I believe the folks in New York and whoever's responsible for this drop in wicket from Adelaide really has failed the World Cup. I think, you know, they have done sort of an atrocious job in really preparing this wicket.
But I'll go out on a limb and say, I think this Pakistan team is in turmoil. They are for the taking. I think this rich, confident US team will beat them tomorrow and set the cat amongst the pigeons. First upset for the World Cup, officially, if you want to put it that way. I think it's coming tomorrow. Welcome to another edition of At The Wicket. I am your host, Kavarly Arnold, alongside co-host Tracey. We have Roger Tracey here with us. We will be looking at a number of topics from the day. Now, when we look at what happened in the world of cricket, we have to look at what happened with India, India's win over Pakistan. We have to also look at what's happening with the pitch. Quite a number of concerns regarding pitch and the outfield. And we will also be looking at some outstanding performances so far in the World Cup, along with USA-Pakistan game for tomorrow. Roger, thanks for joining us.
Of course.
Yeah, let's start at the top here. India, commanding win over Ireland today. We'll talk a little bit about the pitch later on. We'll have that sort of discussion. But let's just focus on the performance of India and maybe a little bit of luck thereof of Ireland, because they looked a better outfit coming into the World Cup. Maybe we expect a little bit more.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, in general, I think this was a commanding performance today from the Indian cricket team. I believe that, you know, for such an outfit, they did what they were supposed to, and that is take care of business. India is the number one team in the world, you know, just based on the caliber of players that represents Team India. Ireland, of course, we know is a formidable outfit, but I believe they're obviously, you know, a couple of notches, a couple of tiers below a team like India. So India did what was expected. Obviously, you know, they had an outstanding bowling performance in getting Ireland out for a small score, and then they were very efficient at their turn at bat. Rohit Sharma obviously leading the way along with Richard Pant. Outstanding performance in India, but again, no surprises, exactly what was expected.
Yeah, you know, when we look at the composition of the India team, I was a little bit surprised to see India going with two spinners, Kuldeep Yadav, maybe their better spinner, sitting on the bench. And going with those two left-arm spinners that can bat, I think it boosted their batting a lot. And the three out-and-out quicks, I think they read the conditions exceedingly well in going with those three quick bowlers today.
Yeah, I mean, reading those conditions of the New York pitch was really sort of a low-hanging fruit. India obviously would have paid attention to the game on Monday between South Africa and Sri Lanka, where Henrik Nortje ripped through the Sri Lankan lineup. So obviously this pitch, it has a, you know, variable bounce, and it obviously was very helpful to the seam bowlers. You know, having said that, you know, I mean, this is a World Cup event for the first time in the United States of America, where, you know, the whole intent should be to sort of gain, you know, this sort of new fan base and tap into the American media market. I think, you know, for any good sort of cricketing event and cricketing games, one of the most important thing to have is a good surface, a good pitch to play on. I believe the folks in New York and whoever's responsible for this drop in wicket from Adelaide really has failed the World Cup. I think, you know, they have done sort of an atrocious job in really preparing this wicket. And, you know, it does not argue well for the World Cup. And hopefully, Dallas and Florida, you know, can have much better services, because the services in New York leaves a lot to be desired. And to think about it, that on Sunday, one of, if not the biggest match in this World Cup, India versus Pakistan, will be played there. Let's hope they have another strip or another, you know, fair within that cricket field that they're going to play on, because I would be, you know, it would be pretty embarrassing if India versus Pakistan and just play on a surface like the one we had today.
Yeah, let me just, before we segue into looking at the pitch in totality, let me just bring the viewers up to pace with what happened in the game. India won by 8 wickets with 4-6 deliveries remaining. You know, Jasprit Bumrah picking up the man of the match, you know, 2 wickets for 6 runs. He was superb. Despite that, he was not the highest wicket taker. Hardik Pandya, brilliant bowling performance from him, taking 4 wickets, taking 3 wickets in it from his 4 overs for 27 runs. I think he lost the plot a little bit in the latter part, because at one point, Ireland were 50 for 8, right? And they labored to get to 96 runs. And then India went in, and I think Rohit Sharma got off to a good start in getting a run. He retired hurt at 52 off 37 deliveries. He got a blow from a ball. It didn't look as serious, but the ball came up, hit him on his shoulder. He went off, retired hurt. But by that time, it was just formality, because despite losing Virat Kohli for a single of 5 deliveries, Rishabh Pant came out, stabilized things with Rohit Sharma, and made 36 and just took the game home. But when we look at the game and the pitch, you spoke about that. Let me just say, in a little bit of defense to the guys who prepared these pitches. These pitches are dropping pitches. I don't know how well our viewers know about dropping pitches. They're built somewhere else and brought to this and brought there dropping. Now, they were brought to they were built in Florida, right, where the conditions are maybe more suited because of the winter. They didn't do it in the likes in New York. However, the guy that do these pitches is from Adelaide. He's a brilliant creator. He's very good at what he does. We don't usually have these issues with him. So I don't think he failed Roger the World Cup, let me put it that way. I think there was a little bit of rush and the logistics was not done properly, because usually when these drop-in pitches usually take at least 6 months to get, you know, level out and just play through the form. However, remember, they recently, I think it was May 1st or somewhere around that time, they brought it from Florida to New York, and they put these pitches in. It's still a lot spicy, a lot of rain around and all of that, and you could see it. Roger, are you any at all worried about what might happen on Sunday?
Well, obviously, you know, it's a massive encounter. And again, we have some of the fastest bowlers in the world. So obviously there is always the concern that someone could get hurt, right? That is always a possibility. My hope is that, you know, they will be put in on a different strip that is potentially better than the strip they played on today and on Monday. The game against the warm-up game, there's a warm-up game between India and Bangladesh over the weekend that, you know, that was played in the same stadium. And I don't think we saw these sort of demons in the pitch on Saturday. So my hope is that they will figure out a way to rectify the situation and, you know, to cause, you know, so that it doesn't lead to more embarrassment.
Yeah, I think they played on one of the side pitches on Monday, and I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that, but I think they're playing on one of the more middle wickets on, because it's four pitches on the square. On one of the middle ones today. I don't know if they will move to another one and see, because hopefully, as you said, with that warm-up game, they played on another one. They hope we can figure things out for Sunday, because it would not be a good spectacle, as you said, Roger, to have this. This is the biggest game of the World Cup. Mm-hmm. Regardless of who gets to the final, we know India-Pakistan is the biggest thing. And to have so many eyes on this game, and then we find ourselves in a situation where it is not a good watch, that is bad for the world. And I think that's what you meant when you were talking about, you know, the curators and the whole situation around the pitch failing the World Cup, and it won't be a good spectacle. So I'm hoping it's something that they can get right.
Oh, absolutely.
We don't want to dwell too long on the pitch. I guess we'll have further discussion as we look to preview that Pakistan India game, maybe Saturday or so. But we have to look at some of the outstanding performances just briefly throughout this World Cup so far. They've been the RBC, some of the small nations. We see Papua New Guinea push the West Indies the other day. We've seen South Africa with a brilliant performance. We've seen Afghanistan You know, so are you impressed with what you've seen so far of the World Cup in the team?
I've certainly been impressed with a lot of the teams. I think the playing field has become a lot more level over the last, 5 to 6 years. Afghanistan was obviously very impressive yesterday in their win over Uganda. So they look outstanding at this point. You know, gone are the days when the so-called, lesser nations would turn up just to be lambs to the slaughter. I believe these nations are all have all improved massively over the years. And the gap between the top nations and the associates have really shrunk. So, a lot of, and it's T20 cricket, right? But the start of a game, it's a leveler. It's a real leveler. So, I believe that we will have some sort of quote unquote upsets, over the course of this tournament. But, I want to caution, folks when we even use that word, because a lot of them won't necessarily be upsets. These are good teams. I mean, the Dutch, these teams are good teams. We saw yesterday Scotland had England under the pump.
And so Dutch covered this setting, no?
They were absolutely under the pump. So England, may have gotten away with that one. So, I think, we should, have a good World Cup. My only concern is the pitches, both in the Caribbean and here in the United States. I'm looking to see, yes, sporting surfaces, but we want even bounce. We want even bounce, and we want good cricket wickets. And hopefully the rain also stays away. That's another major concern in this season.
We want a good contest between bat and ball. And as you mentioned, the rain. I say the weather is the 21st team at this World Cup, because I don't see that, say we have 20 teams, but when you look at what the weather is doing, the England game that rained out, if they have another rained out game, they can be staring down the barrel of an elimination from the World Cup. These are the defending champions. So these are things that we is concerning, and it might just put a little dampener on the World Cup, literally, but I hope that we get a chance to see best quality cricket played. Let's just segue a little bit as we look to wrap into the Pakistan-US game for tomorrow. This is a massive game. It will be played on that it will be played in Dallas, so it's not on that same pitch in New York. But what's your take on that? What's your expectation for US against Pakistan?
I think the United States should be very confident. I think if the United States team have watched Pakistan play T20 cricket over the last 3 to 4 months, they would have seen that there are some issues. They haven't played well. Yes, they did beat Ireland, but Ireland also won, took one of those games off Pakistan. They also didn't look great in England. There has been some political infractions. They have had a change of captaincy. I don't believe a lot of these players are happy with Babar Azam being captain again. So I think there are some holes. There are definitely some holes in this Pakistan outfit, and the United States should be confident and looking to exploit these holes. Another thing is, if you look at the way the Pakistan team plays T20 cricket in 2024, they've really rolled back the years. They've really gone back to sort of that old style of cricket where they're not necessarily getting off the flying starts. I don't necessarily believe they have their opening combination right with opening the batting for them, who I believe he should control the middle. And someone like Fakhar should probably be moving up. But again, that's a problem for them to be concerned about. I think for United States, we should be looking to exploit these deficiencies. And if we play our A game, I see no reason why we shouldn't be able to turn over Pakistan outfit.
Yeah, I've been saying for some time now, as we were leading to this World Cup, that I think Pakistan is the most fragile outfit of this World Cup. And why? And people always say, well, you get two Pakistans. You get the one that will go hard at you, and they'll just come out and they'll go on and win the whole thing, win the tournament, make it to the final. Or you get this the other Pakistan that will come out, all the issues and turmoil in the camp, and then they go out at a good stage. And I don't think any other tournament, well, yeah, they have been, but I think they're really fragile. Now, look, you mentioned the captaincy. Babar Azam lost the captaincy recently. It went to Shaheen Afridi, they took it back from Shaheen Afridi, got it back to Baba Azam. Now, he refused that Shahin Afridi to take the vice captaincy role. There are talks also that maybe Mohamed Rizwan should have gotten the captaincy. As you said, that opening combination is not right. I think Fakhar Zaman should open the innings along with Rizwan, and Baba should be coming at three. You know, there are so many things. Shadab Khan, he is just a utility player in the team currently because he's not bowling at his best. They're pushing him with the bat. I don't think he's the best batter compared to the players that are in the team. So there's so much there. And I've always said, if you see an animal or someone wounded and their scars are healing, but not totally healed yet, if you get a chance in a tournament like this, to open those wounds and let them bleed out, you should do it. It might sound a bit bizarre, and that's because it should be a family-friendly thing, but I don't mean it in a violent way. I'm just saying, if they have scars, sometimes open those wounds. And that's my message to US, because this is a fragile outfit. And if US is looking to get out of the group, Pakistan is here for the taking. I personally think that, and I think they should go for it.
I absolutely agree. I think now was the time. Again, as I mentioned before, all of the associate nations are smaller nations, so to speak. The cricket has improved tremendously. The United States have a good cricket team. They have a number of players who played in full member countries. Players like Andrews House, players like Corey Anderson. They have top class players like Ali Khan. Then you have the likes of Stephen Taylor, Manan Patel. These are good players, and players that are good enough. Aaron Jones, who I didn't mention, who won the last game. These are players that are good enough to take advantage and to really, you know, sort of take advantage of a Pakistan team that I believe right now is not at their best.
Yeah, and if we should just look at form, the form book alone will tell you. Pakistan coming in, poor form, two rained out games and stuff like that in England. They're not coming in good form. You know, losing to Ireland, you mentioned it earlier. And then you have the US coming in off a 4-0 off Canada. Looking at what they did against Bangladesh, coming into the tournament, beating Canada in good fashion, despite allowing Canada to make so many runs, but they chased it like it was nothing. So I think they are coming in with a lot of confidence. As you said, it must be a confident outfit. So they are looking good. Your predictions before we go, Roger?
It's a hard one to predict. I do believe again, Pakistan, you know, having said what I said earlier, I do believe the USA should be confident. I do still believe Pakistan will start slight favorites, but I believe they can be turned over by the United States. For tomorrow, I believe Pakistan is going to win.
Yeah. Well, I'll go out on a limb. I'll say, yeah, if Pakistan show up, if the real Pakistan show up, they should be good enough to beat the US team, because, you know, bigger name player, the statistics alone tell you. But I'll go out on a limb and say, I think this Pakistan team is in turmoil. They are there for the taking. I think this rich, confident US team will beat them tomorrow and set the cat amongst the pigeons. First upset for the World Cup officially, if you want to put it that way. I think it's coming tomorrow.
I wouldn't use the word upset.
Okay, there you have it, listeners and viewers. Thanks for joining us on another edition of At The Wicket. If you have not subscribed this yet, please do so. Share, like, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you again.
Somewhere I feel it in my soul. One chance is everything we've waited for. It's our time, so let me take it home. And knock it out that it's fun.